Namaste. Now we are going to talk about building up how our immune system and our happiness index. In Ayurveda, when you have a good digestion, you have a proper assimilation, and you also have a nice excretion of the metabolic wastes, you start to produce a superfine essence of life that we call ojas. Ojas is not actually only our immunity system. Ojas is not only our contentment and well-being. It's not only endorphins and serotonins and this kind of stuff. It's not only our white cells in the blood and this kind of stuff. Ojas concept is the idea that we are storing life force in our system, and this life force acts as a protector, as a shield to our body. In Ayurveda, we believe that our physical body is enveloped in a more energetic body that we call in the West aura. And the ojas appears in this aura. It's like we have an magnetic electric field around us. And this is created by our own health. When we are very healthy, this bubble of life force is functioning well, and is like destroying the possible things that are going to harm our body. This can be just like a stone that you're going to kick and you're going to fall. This can be another kind of bacteria. This is not actually a mystical thing. It also is, but it's not only. It's the idea that our body produces a electromagnetic field, we call this prana, and when we have a good digestion, when we have a proper assimilation and excretion, our body transforms the food that we eat in ojas. So in Ayurveda, the king of health is Agni, and the queen of wellness is ojas. So, in Ayurveda, if you are willing to empower yourself in a self-health, self-healing Ayurveda management, we are working mainly at Agni, our metabolic process, in order to develop ojas. Because in Ayurveda, there are three main factors for disease. The first is ama, that we spoke before. That is the metabolic toxins, the build-up metabolic toxins, and also environmental toxins, everything that our body cannot digest properly. The second component of disease, illness in the body or in the mind, is what Ayurveda speaks about Vata, Pitta and Kapha, but here we can understand that our physiological functioning gets spoiled, just to put it simple. And the third component of disease is that our body is lacking of life energy in its tissues, and this lackage is missing ojas. So, before I spoke that in Ayurveda we pay more attention to the actor, not to the field. Because if our digestive process is strong, Agni is burning things that are going to be harmful for our digestive process and things that we eat and are not good and this kind of stuff. But if we digest things and the virus or the bacteria survive to our digestive process, our body has the capacity to resist to its attack And this capacity also is ojas. So in Ayurveda, if we develop a good digestive process and a good elimination process, all this concept of agni and malas that we have spoken before, we are able to develop a shield that is going to protect us of the environmental and psychological stresses that we are living. So that's how Ayurveda explains people that eat things that are spoiled and don't get sick, and people that eat things that are healthy and get sick because of these two components, Agni and Ojas. Ojas also is how we feel inside ourselves. You can say in one sense that happiness is feeling well inside yourself. When you're at home or when you're in a place that you like, you feel ease in that place, not dis-ease. And this feeling of being easy with life brings us a kind of mental state that we call joy, happiness. It's not the happiness of like drinking alcohol or making some sensory stimulation to our mind, but the happiness that is cultivated inside, the idea of being peaceful, being contented, being easy inside. This is the idea of Shanti. That usually in the yoga classes people say Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. This idea of being peaceful inside is also related to ojas. When our tissues are strong and they are gathered with good storage of prana, they can face stresses and enemies and things that are trying to kill it. To kill you, maybe. So, in Ayurveda, prana, that is the life force, is related to Agni, the metabolic process of life. These two things work together, just like the air and the fire, and the wood that is going to be burnt is our food. When these three things work well together, they start to make some savings of life energy to periods that are our body may be a little bit stressed up. In this sense, we can say that we are cooking some food with this wood, with this fire and with this air to storage when we are needing to eat. Of course, in Ayurveda, we have a very good prediction about fresh food. Just cook it and eat it. Because when we eat fresh food, the prana is more available. When we eat some food that is just like cooked in the microwave or it's frozen in the fridge and this kind of stuff, it can be with all the vitamins and all the nutrients and the calories and this kind of stuff, but our body loses the capacity to talk with it, to digest it in an energetic sense, in a pranic sense. So in Ayurveda, you can eat and not get nourished, even if the food is with good quality, organic and this kind of stuff. If it's put on the fridge or if it's cooked in the microwave, the prana gets disturbed, just like prana is the arrangement of molecules in the space. It's not actually the molecules. When you do origami with the paper is not itself the origami. The origami, like these brochures that Japanese do, is the organization that you do with the paper. So prana is like this. It's the organization that you do with the molecules. And when you you heat up the food in the microwave, you just smash it and it's not being recognizable. Just like when you go to the market and you put the things that you want to buy in the basket, and then in the cashier, the people pass it from the census. And these small brackets that are there communicating with the machines, if they are just like spoiled, you can pass it, but the system are not going to acknowledge, to recognize the information there. This is the point. In Ayurveda, we don't eat the food itself. The food is the carrier of prana. And when the prana is misled by any kind of silly preparations, we cannot comprehend what to do with this food in the way that our body is going to be deeply nourished. So here we have a little step forward in our concepts. We have prana, that is the life force. We have rhythm, that is the coordination of this life force. We have agni, that is the metabolic process, the digestive capacity, the ability to transform things that are outside us in ourselves. We have the excretion, the waste, metabolic waste products, and we have the vitality essence, ojas, and we also have the metabolic intoxication when these things doesn't work well, and the ojas is not produced, ama is produced. So in Ayurveda is simple. Prana and agni are working to produce ojas, and when we fail in this life easiness, we get spoiled in ama and disease. Okay? So we are now getting a little bit clarified about metabolic process according to Ayurveda, so we can start to talk about more on daily routine and this kind of stuff. If you want to have a consultation and proper guidance for yourself, just contact me at namaste.tiago@gmail.com, and please share, subscribe, like, and all this stuff. Okay? See you in the next video. Namaste.